What's up, y'all? Welcome to the stream. Well, today I'm making some particle optimizations still. So, I got this all working now, actually. If you're following along last stream, I was coding up, basically using OpenGL triangles to do all these particles. And now there's like too many particles. This is supposed to be the snow effect. But it's just like put way too much density into the particles, so there's just a bajillion of them. We'll get this fixed though. So yeah, that's today's goal. Is now that it's all working, right? The GL part's working. The next step is to basically get it to look exactly like it used to, with all the old effects. So yeah, you can tell the flames there on those on those fiery pillars there are also just overloaded with particles. The particle system's a little... It's too eager. Oh, by the way, if you're watching this YouTube video, I got a whole bunch of new marketing materials coming out. New beta trailer. I'll be demoing that here on today's stream later on. New beta trailer! Sweet. It's been too long. Last trailer update was over a year ago. So it's been well overdue. Alright, so we got this anim called Snow, which creates some particles. And I think the density is the problem. Oh wait, maybe not. It's using K-Kind Smoke. Why is the density so huge? Let's find out. So we're creating the particles there. And then in... here in Create Modes, it should be setting a total. Let's find out why that's all weird. Programming Geekery. What's up, Salad? Howdy, man. I'm optimizing them. How you doing today, Salad? So it's not stars, so it's going to be a CLF of the width, density, what is this? Can't view it. Oh, did it get this already? Hold on a second. We want to hit the snow breakpoint first. There, now we want to hit create modes. I'm doing all right too, man. Super positive. What's up, man? How's it going? How you been? Still can't inspect particles. Try again. You got a job? What kind of job did you get, man? There we go. This time we can inspect it. All right, we got width 420 by 240. Density is a half. The question is, what is the inverse tile width? So area block size. Area block size should be 20 by 12. Inverse tile width became 1, though. Oh, I messed this up right here. So I did max one there in for inverse tile width. All right. Social media? Oh, right on, man. Nice. That's a really important job these days. How are you liking it? Oh, I guess if it's zero, those should become one. But if it's like 0.00001, then it's okay. Ah, okay, so I messed that up here. If inverse tile width is zero, or less than equal to zero, even. It's been pretty great. Awesome. That's good to hear. Well, I've been good too, man. I've just been working on Songbringer like crazy. I got it updated to a bunch of backers, or I mean, I upgraded a bunch of backers for free. Oh, it's been a month and a half? Okay. Yeah, so in the spirit of the holiday season, I upgraded a bunch of backers that have been waiting a long time to play the game. The deal was they would get to play the game when it was released, but I just changed the deal. I was like, you know what? You've been waiting so long here. You can play the beta version. So they got a free upgrade. And that's going really well. I've had a lot of new players on Songbringer and a lot of bug reports and things like that, but most of them already been fixed. Already got things rolling there, and so I'm getting closer and closer and closer to releasing, but it's gonna still be a minute before the game's all ready. So let's see what happens now with inverse tile width more proper. Yeah, we're back to like regular snow and regular flames. Man, that was a pretty easy fix. That was super fast. One thing I'm noticing though is that the particles just burst into existence there at the top. How far am I into the game? Like into finishing it? That's, oh man, I don't know how to describe that. The game you could say is mostly finished, but there's still a lot of minor content to be added, so it's really hard to put it, to nail down how far. Definitely in the last 20% of making the game, but that last 20% can take as long as the first 80 did, so you never really know. You can't really put it into like days. You can't put it into months. You can't put it into years. Time is just irrelevant. It's programmer time. So the only thing about that was that the anim snow needs to be a little taller than the area size. Maybe just 16 ought to do it. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Well, this is exciting. This new particle system is so much more performant than the old particle system. The old particle system used textures. Basically, every single one of them was a single pixel texture. What's up, Kovarni? Oh, thanks, super positive. There we go. Now the snow is falling in from the top of the screen. And you can see these little particles coming off the flames here. These are fixed now too. So now we should start getting rain to work. Rain will be the next thing. Oh, let's make sure that this is All good down here. Some particles down here. Yeah, cool. We got a couple of particles like coming in from the top of the ceiling there. Oh, wow. I wonder if the rotation already works too. What's up with the video though? It's going really good, Gavarni. Yeah, I got a new trailer almost finished. In fact, I'll share it with you guys right now. There. Here's the new trailer I've been working on. This is an unlisted video, so it's not quite ready to go out and be shared. But I'll share it with you guys here on the stream so you can tell me what you think. It's almost finished. There's a few little things I want to do left with it. So I'd love to get your guys' feedback and tell me what you think of this video, how it could be better maybe. Oh, all right, man. Oh, I think it had two copies of Songbringer running. No wonder it was so slow. What is going on? All right, let's see. Activity monitor. Why did a copy of Songbringer just get stuck? Well, it doesn't look like it's even there. What's up with that? What? Okay, this is ready to check in. Cool, so snow starts a little bit off the screen and the amount of particles has been fixed. All right, let's go this time. Let's turn on some heavy rain. So that'll move us back so that the game will do heavy rain instead of snow this time. The last time I checked this, the rain wasn't even working at all. So I'll have to figure out why that is. Yeah, so we got no rain. It's good overall. Nice. Any thoughts? So yeah, I can see there's a few different lightning flashes here. Takes too long to get to gameplay. Ah, everybody's okay. A little slow. All right. All right, I'll do that. Cool. Good suggestions, you guys. Awesome. It's good to get your feedback because I've been looking at it like, you know, over and over and over for the last few days. And like, to me, it just looks like, you know, I don't have any objective feedback on it. So thank you for your objective feedback. I really appreciate it. Awesome, right on. Cool. Yeah, I tried to show a lot of the best parts of the game, you know, it's hard to do that with a game that's hard, that's like, you know, your baby or whatever, and like you're like, you know, you've been making this game for so long. So it's hard to like pick the right shots, but I think they're all right. Tetragram, what's up, man? Thanks for the thoughts. All right, super positive. See you, man. Yeah, a little too long. Awesome. I can definitely cut that by about half. I'll have to change the song a little bit for that, but that shouldn't be too hard either. I'll just take out 2 bars of the song and a bit of that flyby. No problem. It's easy. Huh, yeah, that's an interesting idea to cut it up. But that's a lot more work. The software I'm using, Adobe Premiere Pro, sucks ass. It's so bad. It's so bad. The big problem with it is that you make all these edits and stuff, and this is the only software I have to work with, so and then when you make edits, it's like this update, this preview screen is slow as hell, and it almost never works. Like you go and you make a few edits, and then you have to keep pressing play and pressing play and pressing play over and over and over to get it to finally show you what you just did. So for me to go cut it up and then throw bits of the intro in throughout the whole video would be a hell of a lot of work. And secondly, I'm trying to just tell a tiny little story through this trailer. So as you can see, like it first shows you the intro of the ship, and then it shows you him getting the sword, and then he starts adventuring, and then there's you get the bombs, and there's the bridge, then you fight a boss, and then eventually you wake up Vel. You know, so it's kind of telling you a story. And if I were to throw the intro in throughout the story like that, it would kind of mess with the flow of the narrative, I think. But it's a good suggestion. I really like that idea. Yeah, thanks for that. Okay. So yeah, I'll do that later on tonight. I wish I could do that kind of stuff on the stream, but editing video is already hard enough, you know, on my CPU and GPU. Okay, so let's get the work this working now with the rain. Something's up with the rain. It's just not even there. And there is some special logic going on with rain. Bye, baby.
Jeans and
All right. See you. How could I fix that without breaking? Because it all lines up with that last audio. That last audio lines up really, really good. I don't know what to do about that. I also like how it ends on that, on this one little this image right here at the end kind of works nicely. I guess I could maybe put it at the beginning. So like this could go at the very beginning. Or maybe it shows like half of the ship here and then shows that proc gen. Huh. Hold this longer? You mean just hold it like there longer? Or like there longer? Like with, or like here longer? Oh no, game show's ruining it today. Oh, I was supposed to do something special when this happened. Oh, totally, I could do that. Yeah, okay, I can definitely do that. Just hold it at the very, very end for a second. It's supposed to do that, or I mean, videos are... Nah, that's a good point. It's a really good point, because some video players, it depends on your video player what happens here at the end, but some of them, what I'm intending to do for video players to happen is just to, for it to stop right there on this screen, but some video players might show it with a black, one black frame or something like that, even though there's not supposed to be one, even one black frame at the end. What's up, Zyger? How's it going, man? Zanger, I'm getting some feedback on the this new beta trailer. I'll send you the link here. Oops. So here, there's the new trailer. Well, this is not the new trailer. This is an unlisted video. I'm just looking for feedback here. This is not ready to be shared yet. Is it possible to move the camera picture and not ship at the intro? Yeah. So the YouTube experience for it is that the title shows up and then immediately goes away. Oh, is that what's happening right now? What's up, Vlad? What's up, man? You just finished your first semester of college? Right on, man. That's awesome. Oh, it does. It totally just like... ends it right then, but I think it's ending on a black screen. I think it might have rendered one frame at the very end. I think there actually is like one black frame here. And that's what's going on. Yeah. Totally. There's one black frame. Okay, I can get that fixed too. It's going good, blood. Mr. Frenick, what's up, man? Bro, endless number? Bronliest? Bronliest! I get it. Yeah, what's up? I was just sharing this new work in progress trailer. Love to get you guys' thoughts on it. The link's right there in the chat in case if you didn't get it, I can post it again. But yeah. Nice, Salad. I appreciate all the feedback. It's so awesome. Yeah, I'll fix that. Nice. I'm glad you like that part. Okay, game show is still using my entire CPU, both of my cores. So I might have to reset it or something. Oh, there's something I was supposed to do. I like messaged the people from the Make Game Show and they're like, next time it does that, do this. Nice, yeah, that's what took so long to make is like, I'm like, okay, I gotta record this one at 60 frames a second. So it took a lot more, time to make because the GPU is so intensive. I had to turn everything else off and, you know, record at 60 frames a second and retina quality. So this is 1920 by 1080p. So it's a 1080p video at 60 frames a second, which is hard for my old laptop from 2013. Okay, let's see what we can do about this game show issue. Is it game show? No. What was I supposed to do? I don't know. This is killing it though. When game show eats up this much CPU, like I can't even code. Oh yeah, how did you guys' finals go? Ah, man. I'll see how long I can stream with it like that. Wait, maybe I should close Premiere. Still didn't help. All right, anyways. Okay, so let's figure out what's up with rain. Rain uses the rotation. Oh, rain uses a different blend funk. I wonder if it's that. What's up, Rocket Bunny? You think you passed? Right on. Nice, man. You're using Tmux already and Vim. All right, I'm hoping it was just that with the additive. Zanger, you think you passed too? How do you enable Vim plugins? You need something like Pathogen or Vundle. All right, still we got nothing. All right, well, we'll set a breakpoint. So here's where it does the enims rain. We need another breakpoint where it's creating all the particles, just to make sure it's creating particles at all. Use Emacs. Oh, you use Sublime? I know, I'm having a tough time switching from Xcode. I can use Vim for most stuff, but when it comes to debugging, it's a lot easier to use Xcode. Or there's Pathogen. Pathogen is really nice. It's more lightweight than Vundle. Oh, Salad. So can you set breakpoints from Emacs and you can set them in Xcode? That would be awesome. All right. 420, 360. Vec is like that. So the total is 2,000 particles of rain. And they're like all invisible. Okay, so maybe it's the rotation. Let's try that. Oh, you haven't tried that? Still, we got nothing. I wonder if the rain is off the screen for some reason. Do a little camera zoom out to try and figure that. Okay, still we have no rain. I wonder if we go to a different area though. Like maybe it's just no. Okay, it's definitely, we just have no rain whatsoever. What else could it be? Could it be the vector maybe? I know there's a bunch of particles. Oh, I got it. What if instead of using, let's use a different kind. Let's just use smoke. So I know that works. Yeah, good advice from Solid there. Use Vim Adventures, Vim Tutor. Both those are things you should be doing first. Okay, cool. So it is the kind rain. Obviously we have some, this is working here. If I set it to kind smoke, if I set it to kind rain, nothing happens. So it's gotta be some of this logic here with K kind rain. Oh, it could be the bounds, I guess. Try that. What's up, PDG? It's good to see someone who's not using Unity or Unreal. Awesome, man, right? Man, my biggest pet peeve with those game engines, I think they're awesome game engines, don't get me wrong. I think people are making some great games with those game engines too, but the one thing that bugs the hell out of me is that people don't pay that much attention to performance with those game engines. People use Unity and they make 2D games, freaking 2D games in Unity that perform so badly that my laptop, like, the fan is constantly running. Bugs the hell out of me. I'm like, this is not a game that's requiring very much from my GPU at all, but the developer here doesn't care about performance. And it's so easy with Unreal and Unity to not do the right thing with performance, because it's just, the way it comes out of the box is just really bad. You know, it just uses so much GPU. So, and there are ways in Unity and Unreal to make them perform really well, but you have to like, work at it. You have to be like conscious of that. You have to like render things to a frame buffer, for example. Yeah, right. What? Vim Tutor was written by some people from your school? Dude. Oh, I know, right, Mr. Frenick? There are so many ways to make a 2D game perform bad. don't atlas them well. Another huge thing though is that you, is that if you don't render things to a frame buffer, then you end up basically for every, like if you're running a game like on my laptop, for example, this is my resolution here is 2560 by 1800, which is like twice the resolution of most screens or whatever, because it's got twice the pixels. It's a retina display. So the big thing there is that if you're not rendering it to a frame buffer and then scaling your frame buffer up to whatever resolution is at, you're actually going with every single one of your sprites, you're rendering like four times the pixels. So your GPU is like on fire because it's having to do so much more work. It's crazy. Yeah. Anyways, so, but that aside, you can still write a game in Unreal and Unity that performs really, really well. You just have to do the right things. You have to care, first of all. And that too. Yeah, there's a lot of engine overhead. And C# performance. You know, that's not all that awesome either. But those are not as important as the 2D part or the GPU. Yeah. Okay, so I'm still trying to figure out why the rain is the one kind of particle which is not working. I just disabled that. I know it's not the total. I disabled the blend funk additive. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. General purpose engines. That's a problem with general purpose languages too. Anything that's general purpose is not going to be very souped up. Ah, the difference between who wants to make games and an exploratory exercise. Cool. It's a part of who you are? Awesome. Okay, let's comment out this little bit. One of these things has got to be it. So yeah, if you're just tuning into this stream, what I'm trying to do is I'm upgrading my particle systems to be more optimal, and somehow the rain is not working anymore. So it wasn't that. It's not that. I guess it could be this, but probably not. Oh, right, and memory allocations that happen at runtime? Totally. That happens to an extent with Cocos 2DX as well. It's not very memory optimal. You can hear the rain. You can't see the rain. Where'd you go, rain? Okay, it wasn't that, of course. There's kind stars, waterfall, rain. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, in theory, that's what you're supposed to do. Aren't all RANs deterministic? Well, yes, but not on all platforms. So you would, if you want to make a deterministic random number generator that runs exactly the same on every platform, you got to use one of those kind of random number generators. But no, not yes, if you're running it on exactly the same platform and seeding it the same way every time, you're going to get the same random numbers. Okay, is it this? Good Lord, man. Huh. Rocket Bunny, did you load Pathogen? You need to execute a couple lines in your vimrc to load Pathogen. This is it right here. It's just one line. Execute Pathogen infect. Did you do that? This line right here. Did you do this? You gotta have this, man. That makes it load all your things. And then you also have to have your autofunc. And then you also have to have your vim things in a folder called, is it autoload? Yeah, you gotta have pathogen.vim in an autoload folder, and then you've gotta have your the bundles that you want loaded by pathogen have to go in the bundle folder. Is there anything special about the permissions? I don't think there's anything special about permissions, but you should check those. Check your permissions. So that didn't work either? I don't remember. What's up with the rain? So it wasn't that? Oh, is this it? Is it just the opacity? Could just be opacity. That would make a lot of sense. Oh, that was it. It was the opacity. Yes. Oh, it's good to know what's wrong. Now I can undo all this stuff. See, we're supposed to set the opacity. Okay, so if I go back and make it so it uses this automatic opacity here, does everything else still work? Debugging. One thing at a time. The divide and conquer method. It doesn't look anything like the old rain, but we're getting there. It's starting to be like the old rain. That's cool. Okay, so the opacity, that needs to be right. That was all it was? I thought I had opacity set right here. Something got it overwritten, maybe? So if I put that uncommented. Everything's invisible. All right, what if we just have m dot opacity equals 255? Is it? Oh, I think there's something around. Oh, that's it right there. Okay, this was just out of order the whole time. Alright, so if we have kind rain, we got this kind of color. Let's put this freaking how it should be. There, rain, you pick a color at the very beginning. Same with opacity, you pick an opacity before you run the update. So instead of changing your opacity every single one of the updates, it just picks an opacity and sticks with it. Ooh, whoops. All right, there. Choose an opacity, stick with it. Choose a color, stick with it. Oh, this is M dot, this is just kind. Oh, not moat rain, kind rain. Oh, and this needs to override. This should override that. Okay, I'm getting there. If this works, the next thing will be to get it to rotate. Cool. Yay, we're starting to have rain again. SQL gurus, show yourselves. I wonder if you can just rotate the parent node. Let's try that first. Particles. Set rotation 10 degrees. And my computer is so slow because game show's got a problem right now. The thing I'm using to stream, it's eating up both of my CPU cores. Wait a minute, I think it worked. You can rotate those all those little entities like that. That's pretty cool. So if I had no rotation, so no sidewaysness. So this is nothing there. And then we had a deeper rotation, so let's go all the way to exactly 45 degrees. What's up, Beach Knee? It does work. You can rotate like that. We do have a problem there, though. The problem is if we rotate the entire particle system, then when you want, oh, there's this one little effect where when the rain hits the ground, it goes splash and like does this like perfect like thing on the flat ground. So if the whole particle system is rotated, then that little splash will happen at a rotated angle too. So we can't really use that technique. We've got to rotate each individual one of these particles. Hey, Clone Geek, what's up, man? Have you made a profiler? Have I used a profiler? Yes, I have. I use a profiler very frequently, especially when I'm doing things like this with optimizing particles. Let me show you. The very last time I just did some profiling was this morning, and let me see if I can find what I made this morning with profiling. Yeah, particles optimization. So here's before. If it splashes, you have the event of it happening. Yeah, totally. Yeah, I know when the event happens, and I guess I could anti-rotate it or whatever. But I just want to. I think it's simpler just to keep the system at no rotation, and then just rotate the individual particle so that when it hits the ground, you can turn off its individual rotation. Yeah. So this is this morning, right? This is before I optimized. Actually, this is not a very good example of before optim. Well, you're not seeing any GPU time spent here, but this was spending a lot of GPU energy. Because what this was, this old system was using huge textures, like 1680, where the screen is only 420. So we're talking four times the width of the screen, and 12 of those textures like that big. So it was just really, really inefficient compared to the new particle system. And then this is after the fourth time. Look how much less time it's already using rendering and overall. So yeah, I profile a lot. And I use this profiling tool called Instruments for Mac. It comes with Xcode. It's pretty good. I like it. I only wish you could do your GPU. There's like I haven't really found a very good way to profile your GPU. If anybody knows of how to do that, please tell me. I would love to know how to profile my GPU. Okay, so when it comes to individual rotation, it's going to be like this. We're not using the rotation here. Yeah, IDEs do that. Oh yeah, that would definitely be a hassle to write your own profiling. Yep. Sequel, anyone, please? Does anyone know Sequel? Remotary, is that another profiling app or something? Oh, it's for the GPU? Tell me it is. What? Is it for Windows? No way, it's for all platforms. Oh my God, Mr. Frenick, you're an angel, man. You're my hero, seriously. Okay, so you have to kind of like hook it into your code, but that doesn't seem too hard. Oh my God, I can't wait to try this. And it does your CPU? This is so great. Wow. Cool. So cool. Awesome. I can't wait to try that. They give cycles. Cool. All right. So we're going to do a rotation sine and rotation cosine if the kind is rain, then we're going to get a rotation. We don't need to make it degrees. So we'll get the first mode's angle, or I mean vector, get its angle. Add pi, make that negative. There's our rotation. And then rot sine equals sine f rotation. This wrote cosine cos f. Okay, so now we've got a sine and a cosine. Now we can use those to rotate the triangles that we're rendering for each one of these rain particles. Oh, and if I make it 1.0, I can just multiply every single one of these. Okay, so yeah, the rotation sine starts at 1, cos starts at 1. And then when we're setting our triangles, we modify the other points. So we'll do x times the cosine and y times the sine. The same thing for this other triangle. Beer time! Woo! I don't know, Rocket. It's weird. I don't get any errors. So the Y is the rot sine. All right. I'm not sure if this is going to work or not, because I'm not so great at trigonometry. I think this is the general idea. We got two triangles here. We're using cosine and sine to rotate them based on the vector that the rain is falling at. Okay, now it's like they're not even. Not long anymore. Let's undo this and see, make sure that just multiplying by, I didn't mess anything up there with that math. Claim Linux. Okay, yeah, that's working. I guess it was just that the sine and cosine thing. Huh. Okay. When it comes to trigonometry and stuff, or other kinds of basic math, I always have to draw pictures. All right, so if we have, this is the starting, the way it used to be, right? We've got this point. We're going to draw a single pixel, which is made up of two triangles. We've got one triangle like that and another triangle like this. This is scale X. And this is scale Y. This is the point of the pixel, and this is the point of the pixel plus scale X plus scale Y. You have a hard time with math, right? Okay, so if I want to rotate that, right? Let's say I have a, I want to rotate it 45 degrees, negative 45 degrees, or just 45 degrees, whatever. Negative 45 degrees, we'll say. So we still got the starting point of the pixel. But if we've rotated 45 degrees, we'll have a triangle kind of like this and this. right? This is X, this is Y. It's perfect drawing, I don't know. So this point right here, this is where it used to be, right? And we're drawing essentially a sine curve. Like that, I think. Is that right? Yeah, I think we're using a sine wave here. Essentially, this would be a circle. If you traced all these, if you just rotated this single point right here around this whole thing with the same distance, it would just trace a circle. Yes, I know that, right? Translate, rotate, then translate. Is that what you have to do? The finite and discrete math problem solver? Otherwise, you have to take your anchor into account. Right, but I'm kind of confused though, because let's say we're talking about just this point right here, right? If I translated it to the origin, this point, if you rotate it around the origin, it's not going to do anything. Right? I can rotate a pixel or just a single point in space over and over and over and over. It doesn't change because it's only one dimension. Still confused. I don't know what to do with this math. Right. Okay. So let's just say this is one. This is 1, 0. This is 1, 1. This is 0, 1. Math is the language of the universe. What's the problem? I want to rotate a rectangle. That's all I'm trying to do. So if this is 0, or this is 0, 1, right? And this is 0, 0. So all I want to do is, like, let's say I want to rotate this whole rectangle at an arbitrary angle, but let's just say that for now this is a 45 degree angle, right? So the point that's 0, 0 will stay the same, but the point that was 1, 0, what does that become? I'm rotating it from 0, 0. It really doesn't matter. The origin is always 0, 0. Oh, is that what you were saying, Mr. Frenick? Oh, okay. I was taking that for granted that this is 0, 0. So yeah, this is always going to be 0, 0. The Cocos 2DX handles the math for the rest of that kind of stuff. Oh, thank you, Blood. Good job, Rocket. Yeah. Right. Imagine a point located at XY. If you want to rotate that point around the origin, the coordinates of the new point would be located at X. Oh, okay. So I knew it had to do something to do with cosine and sine, but I didn't know it was X prime equals X cosine minus Y sine. Yeah, and this is what Mr. Frenick was saying right here about transiting it to the origin first. Ooh, nice. New. Nice. Whoa. Whoa. I can't get, I can't let go. Okay. So there's our math right there. Okay, so here's what it was originally. Let's just say if if the sine is not zero or cosine is not zero. We'll do some special rotating math here. Otherwise, we do our normal math here. High school flashbacks. Yeah, the matrix multiplied. I wanted to avoid the whole a huge matrix though. The way Cocos does it is it actually does a huge 4x4 rotate matrix rotation for every single node, for every single tick. And I want to do this simpler because I want to do a really fast particle system. So I'm just calculating the sine and the cosine once before it updates all these particles. And since I've already got those, I'm just going to try and make the math as simple as possible. So we're going to need X prime and Y prime. We'll just say whatever, X equals the original x times cos. So the original x is going to be this times the cosine minus yeah. The rectangle is at the origin. Could do a table, totally. But this is before, this runs before it updates all of these particles, so it really doesn't matter. I can calculate sine and cosine once per tick. That's totally fine. And then this is minus y times the sine. So the y is mpos plus scale y times rot sine All right, float Y is so the Y times the cos plus the X times the sine. Okay, so now we go from M pos X, M pos Y to our X prime, M pos Y, X prime, Y prime, and this one is X prime, Y prime, Y prime. There we go. So that's X, XY, XY, X prime, Y prime. Yeah, so that's one of the triangles. And this one is the origin, X prime, Y prime, original XY. Yeah, that's right. Cool. Let's hope that works. Oh, right, yeah. Cash misses. How does the C standard library do it? I think they actually compute sign, right? Oh, crap. What the hell happened? Looks like we got a lot of rain here. Some really big rain particles. All right, I'm going to set every single particle to be invisible except for the first one. Oh, okay, so the positions aren't from the origin, that's the problem. Huh. Hardware stored, really? Okay, so this is from the origin. This is just M scale X. Oh, still doing it. Oh. Oh, then we need to add back in. Okay, right. So it's just m.pos.x plus that stuff. And this is m.pos.y plus that stuff. Damn. Wow, it implements many different algorithms. Its first job is to look at X and decide which algorithm to use. Oh. Essentially trying to write software to beat the FPU is futile. Okay, kiddies, time for the pros. Right? Yeah. Wow. Principle of locality. Place related data close in memory. Right, salad. Was laughing at number two. Standard vector versus standard list. Elements of a vector are stored in contiguous memory, and it's much more cache friendly than in a list. All right, that uses pointers. Try to adapt your data structures and order of computations in a way that allows maximum use of the cache. This is an important one here. Avoid unpredictable branches. Modern architectures feature pipelines. Compilers are becoming very good at reordering code. Ah, oh, damn, I closed it. Cache compactness and avoiding waste. All my components are contiguous for each system, and for locality, I try never to call them outside of a tight loop. All right, back to it. Yeah, blood, nice, man. How do you vertically split the terminal in Tmux? I don't know, man. You're gonna have to look that command up. Okay, so what did I do wrong here? Let's try and take off this opacity thing. Impos X plus scale times rock cos. Is it working now? Let's go for a really, really crazy amount of rain angle. Sidewaysness, we'll just hack up sidewaysness to be 0.5. Are you gonna make me type sidewaysness, huh? So this should do a 45 degree angle, I think. Yes, it is, but it's making the all the rectangles really big. Wonder what that is. Let's set the second triangle to be invisible. See you, Cavani. It does look like a hailstorm, right? It went from a rainstorm to a hailstorm. Hey, we'll just call this one hail. So there, now we got some. Now they're all triangles. Oh, okay, we're gonna need to use rotated points for these as well. So, oh, hell no. This is the regular XY, the X prime. crime. Okay, so we've got this is a this should be like X1, Y1. And we'll make an X0, Y0 as well. X0 is just X plus no Y. So that gets eliminated. Y0, we don't add in the X. So it's just that. So this is XY to X1, Y0. This one is XY to X0, Y1. Hopefully that's correct. Maybe. Okay, let's turn it on for both. Okay, we're getting closer. I think it's just rotated at the wrong angle now. So we're adding plus pi. Might not need that plus pi. The dynamic list code should be cache friendly. Nice, man. Bloom. Yeah. Nice, Mr. Frenick. Yeah, dude, blooming it. Sweet, man. It looks good. Nice job, man. How long did it take to do that? All right, these are definitely rain particles. I mean, they're definitely long, but they're now flat. They're exactly the wrong angle. So maybe it needs to now add back in this plus m pi, or it might be minus m pi. Half a pi, I mean. Yes. nice. The Reigns of the Wrangle! Woo! It's still kind of like, I want to turn off the bloom though on the rain. I wonder if that's possible. Why wouldn't I have done that before though? Particles, that set camera. You implemented it, work? Oh, you did it work already and then you kind of did your own at home? Nice, you figured out a better way? Cool. I feel like I did too for Songbringer. I did it in one extra frame buffer instead of like three or whatever. I don't know. It's possible to do it a lot more efficient than the standard bloom. Bloom weights. Oh, you do a weighted like algorithm like that? Mine's crazy simple. It just does like only the 2 pixels near it. So that should put the rain on top of everything, but it'll render it after the bloom. Or it should. Let's see if this works. Okay. See, it's the sum of all those weighted curves. Nice. Now the rain isn't all shiny. But it's still kind of at a weird angle. Or it's like one of the triangles is still kind of, I don't know, it's funny. Let's scale things up. I'll slow down time this time. Yeah, it looks better without the bloom, but it still looks weird because the pixels or the rain particles are the wrong shape still. They're like triangulars or something. Yeah, you can see clearly now. They're definitely triangles. Oh, are they blurry? Okay, no, they're not blurry. Triangles are falling from the sky. They're like icicles. They're like dangerous icicles. Huge dangerous icicles falling. Falling slowly. Okay, so next goal, make them so they're not triangles. They're supposed to be lines. I think it's calculating, so it's calculating like one of the things, right? Like, I think it's in this math I just did. Stay in school. Azimris, what's up, man? Did I see the bug you sent? Which one? Where did you send it to me? How did you send me this bug? Was it an email? Was it a tweet? Was it a message on something else? Okay, once again, we're gonna turn one of the triangles off just to focus on the one at a time. Oh, and now it looks good. So it must be that I just did one of the triangles wrong. In fact, let's turn off the first triangle and turn on the other triangle. Oh, you sent a link on Steam? Oh, I don't know. I checked it just a few hours ago. Did you send it just recently? That's Bruce's bad explanation. Oh, I need to know where you were. Yeah, this happens sometimes on some areas. Okay, so I need to know your world seed and approximately where you were. Like compared to, for example, the home screen, maybe you were like four screens to the right of the home screen and three screens up or something. Okay. Cool. Yeah, I've seen that bug before. A few times, but it's kind of one of those things I have to like individually fix each one of those because I like having that in there where it can kind of be a glitch in some situations. It's kind of a cool glitch, you know, so I want to kind of leave that whole, I want to fix the individual ones basically. Design decisions. Okay, yeah, so that triangle is totally broken. It's not using the right triangle coordinates. Starting with mpos.x, mpos.y, going to x1, y1, and then x0, y1. I guess the only thing that could be broken here is x0, which has got to be broken because I'm using scale y times cos here. This would have been x equals x0, scale x is 0, and we're only using scale y times sine negative. Okay, here's the problem. Yay! Okay, let's put the two triangles together now. Damn it. Okay, I still mess it up somehow. All right, Blood, see you, man. thanks, bud. See you, man. I thought it was just XR0. XR0YR1. Let's start this over here. XR0YR0. XR0 is impos that. Oh, whoops. Okay, so scale X is going to be 0. Thought that's what I already did in that last calculation. And then this one has a scale Y of 0. Oh, it's like it's so close. Still got the math messed up though somehow. What color scheme am I using? Monokai soda. Harrison Parch, what's up, man? You asking me how long my latency is? What do you mean? Ah, man, I'm getting tired of debugging these triangles. Oh, shadows, yeah. You're procrastinating. Nice, man. If you stream your own channel? If I stream my own channel, you mean if I watch my own stream? I don't know, I've never tried it. Okay, so those triangles are messed up. But I thought they weren't with the old math. I don't know, Harrison. I don't know what my delay is. It would be infinite. Azarus, Azumi and home one up, six right. Let's check it out. I'm tired of working on these freaking triangles anyway. See that time it worked. So that y r zero is m pos dot y plus scale y times rock cos. Oh, see, this is messed up. That's not what that is. Or wait, no, it oh, I just messed this up here. God damn, this is so confusing. This is supposed to be m dot scale y, and this is supposed to be zero. Dang. Okay, so the seed is as in me, and we go one up, six right. So that would be eight, or I mean, six right, that's 15. Is this it? So hold on. I am. No, this isn't six right. Okay, this is seven right or eight right maybe. So it's either this one or this one. Is it this maybe? It might be this one, huh? No? Or wait, maybe here. Nice, Harrison. To the right of the healing thing, then at the bottom right. Oh, okay. Oh, here? Okay, so I can walk up here and then walk onto these rocks. Okay. Cool. Thank you, Azenris. Thank you so much for letting me know exactly where this is. Yeah, these are ones I have to individually fix. So some of them I kind of like to leave in there. You know, it's like, cool, this world has a glitch where you can walk onto these rocks. Because what's the worst that happens? You can walk onto these rocks and then walk to this area. In a cool, maybe that actually might be really cool in some worlds to leave these kind of glitches in. But I will fix as many of these as I can. So anyways, this is 1310 as in me. Thank you, Azarus. All right. Another bug on the list. 119 cards, man. It just grows every week. I've got to do like an entire week where I just fix bugs, and maybe I can get half of these done. Seriously. Okay, so back to getting these triangles to be looking right. Oh, we gotta go back to this seed. So we got the rain. I don't know, Rocket. It probably is. Okay, one of the triangles is right. It's like really skinny though. That's cool. It's fine. So yeah, so that means that YR0 is correct. But XR0 might be not correct. I don't know. Meh! Triangles! Rotating! Geometry! Trigonometry! Aye! Damn. Okay, so the other triangle's wrong. Yeah, all right. These triangles are too big. So that must mean that XR0 is wrong. Either that or all this math is wrong. So going from the origin to XR1, YR1. XR0, YR1. I guess I suppose I could set a breakpoint here. See what this math is actually coming out to be. Okay. This particle is M. M has a position of -47.5 to 74.7. XR0 is coming out to be -48.8, which is, yeah, just rotated slightly that way. And then its YR0 is higher, 277. And then its XR1 is -48.0. YR1 is 277.84. All that seems okay. Huh. me rewrite this. This bit so it seems more, I don't know. Seems more like XY. Because the way they wrote it on this website, this is XY, and then this Y is YX, which is super confusing to me. So the Y, make that X, XX, YY, XX, YY, and then the YR0 would become, oh wait, YR1 is XY, yeah, so wire 0 would become y plus scale x times sine 0 times cos, right? This is x plus 0 times cos minus y times sine. And this is y plus x times sine. X times sine plus 0 times cos. Okay. If this doesn't work, I'm just going to take a break. My poor head. Oh, my poor head. That looks like it made it worse. Oh, man. Oh, well, shit. I guess that's going to be it for today's stream, guys. So, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. Hope you all have a great night. I'm going to take a break. Get some dinner. Come back to this with a fresh mind. And I'm sure the answer will come. I'll be like, oh, it's just that the triangle, blah, blah, blah. It's always easier when you've had a break. So this is getting closer, though. At least I understand how the math is supposed to work, sort of. So anyways, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. We'll catch you all next time. Have a good one.